Do you have a friend who you're always there for, but when you're in need, they ghost you or offer minimal energy or support? Basically, are you in a friendship where it's always all about them? Well, today I'll teach you the five things you can do with people who are takers, not givers. I'm Dr. Abby Medcalf, and I help people think differently so they can make real changes and be happy in all their relationships. Make sure you subscribe and give a like to the video if you like what you hear. So step one is you have to figure out your why. You need to have an honest conversation with yourself first about why you stay in this friendship. What are you really getting out of it? And you're gonna need to dig deep here, and there might be some harsh truths you need to face. So, you know, maybe you like to feel needed. Maybe they're your entry into a certain friend group you'd otherwise not have access to. Maybe you feel more important because they count on you. Maybe you think this is the best you can do and that it's better than nothing. Not true. You know, it's just important to know that there's something you're getting out of this, and you've got to get clear on that or you won't be able to change the friendship. Step two is to track your feelings. The big issue is that you've been minimizing your needs and taking probably blame for things you shouldn't for a long time. So it's time to get real. If you were gaining weight and couldn't figure out why, I'd tell you to track your food so you could get a reality check and some perspective. And the same holds here. So after each interaction with this friend, I want you to track how you feel. You can write down an actual feeling, or I make it really simple. I do a scale of 1 to 6, with 1 feeling drained, alone, resentful, or frustrated, and 6 being uplifted, nourished, connected, and loved. And after any type of interaction with them, you'd put yourself on the scale. And I mean every interaction, including if they don't text you back for 7 hours. So make a note of how you feel, just one of those numbers, and track it for about 2 weeks, but no longer than a month. And you're really gonna see something, because tracking your feelings in this way is important because, you know, friendships are there to support us and help us feel loved and safe. If you're consistently not feeling that way with this friend, it doesn't matter why. It just matters that you feel that way. So even if it's your fault because you're too sensitive, which I think is BS, by the way, I doubt that's the reason, the fact that you feel this way is important and needs to be addressed. That might mean that you need to go to therapy or take a self-esteem workshop or read a book, but moving forward with nothing changed needs to not be an option. All right, step three, talk to them now that you're clear about why you stay and how you feel, right? So now that you're clear, talk to them. It's time to do something inside the friendship. It's time to really go in there. So the first thing is that I want, you know, be honest and talk to them about how you feel. You can use the I feel formula, and you can download that below. I talk about that in other videos. It's a game changer. It's basically using I feel, when you, and I need in a format so that you can kind of stay there to really give good feedback. It's free, link below the video. Two is, you know, don't blame or criticize, but be clear and forward about what's happening for you. And the third thing is you have to have a plan ready for next steps. You know, for example, I don't know, maybe you set a timer when you speak to each other. You know, you do that for a while. Maybe you set up ground rules like no interrupting or calling out dismissive language. Maybe you do that. Maybe you have a code word for when you're feeling dismissed. But you have to have this conversation, and you got to be direct. And it's really good to use that sort of little model I just gave you to keep it on track. Step four is really about learning when to stay. You know, if the friendship slips back into old negative patterns, you got to say something. You can refine, you know, what you agreed on. You can remind them what you agreed to, or you can come up with a new action plan. If this friend is truly capable of friendship, which I hope they are, then you can move yourself towards a mutually loving relationship. Just remember that it won't be a perfect straight line. It's not, you know, they're not gonna be perfect at this, neither are you. You're just looking for an overall upward trend, you know, not perfection. So, but it's really important to keep on track. And, you know, step five, it's to really know if it's time to move on. If you've done everything you can and this person just won't make consistent changes, and you still walk away from conversations or interactions feeling yucky, you've got to put on your big boy or your big girl pants and, you know, you got to move on. It's really time to do that. So there you go. That's my five-step plan for dealing with those one-sided friendships with those people who are takers and not givers. I come out with videos like this every week, so make sure you subscribe and hit the like, and definitely come over to my website if you want more great information like this, abbymedcalf.com, and I've got tons of free information, tons of free tools for you to really be happier in all your relationships.